हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू अनदर लेक्चर ऑफ द सीरीज जेंडर स्टडीज प्रेजेंटेड बाय द सीएसएस वर्ल्ड। इन दिस वीडियो आवर टॉपिक इज जेंडर एनालिसिस ऑफ डिपेंडेंसी थ्योरी। लेट्स स्टार्ट दिस लेक्चर नाउ। बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टडी द जेंडर एनालिसिस ऑफ डिपेंडेंसी थ्योरी, वी विल फर्स्ट कवर द स्लाइट अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द थ्योरी इटसेल्फ। हाउएवर, दिस थ्योरी हैज़ ऑलरेडी बीन कवर्ड इन अनदर लेक्चर इन डिटेल, द लिंक ऑफ विच इज अवेलेबल इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन। Dependency theory. Keep in mind that dependency theory is one of the theories of development. It came in system during 1960 to 1970s. This theory basically rejected the modernization theory. It argues that underdeveloped countries are not only older versions of developed countries, but in fact the wealthier countries of today have become wealthier by exception. This theory rejects the concept of modernization theory, which says that internal resources are very important, which determine economic capabilities development. And it says that besides internal factors, there are external factors also. Modernization theory talks more about the internal factors, but this theory gives more importance to external factors like how one country is doing trade, with which countries it is doing trade, how it is exploiting the other countries, or how it is being exploited by the other countries. So these all external factors matter a lot in the progress and development of a particular country. Wealthy countries exploit natural resources and cheap labor of poor countries. In this point, we can see that one is exploiter and other one is affectee. In simple words, we can see that one country is exploiting and other one is being exploited. In such a situation, both the countries are facing totally different circumstances. The country which is exploiting the other is in better position and have good options for progress and development. On the other hand, the country which is being exploited is not in good condition and is not having the good options for progress and development. So in such situation, the rich countries influence poor nations by controlling economics, media, politics, banking, finance, education, culture, sports, etc. These rich countries have different mechanisms through which they exploit the poor countries. IMF is one of the examples of such mechanisms. When IMF gives loan to a country, then it influences the internal policies of the country. It asks the country to do reforms of its own choice. These rich countries counter all the attempts made by dependent nations to resist their influences by means of economic sanctions. Whenever these poor countries try to come in competition or even try to get some power, then these developed countries become an hurdle for them promptly. We can take an example of Iran. Iran worked for its nuclear program and faced sanctions from United States and other big powers because these developed countries don't want to see underdeveloped countries, developed states. Definition of development by dependency theorists. Dependency theorists define development as ability of countries to being free from exploitation and being able to define development according to their own needs and not directed by external pressures. So under this theory, if a state is independent in making its decisions and is not being exploited by the other states, then it is said to be development. It means that under this theory, the core countries are the only countries which can do progress and development because they exploit the semi-periphery and periphery countries. After developing the basic understanding of dependency theory, now we will study the gender analysis or gender criticism on this theory. Gender analysis of dependency theory. While keeping the basis of dependency theory in mind, we will see that how this theory can be implemented in gender relations. Under dependency and world system theories, we have studied that core and semi-periphery countries exploit the periphery countries. Such a relation can be viewed between males and females also. Men use patriarchal system to keep the women in the state of dependency towards men. It is socially constructed that society makes women dependent on men. Usually it happens that women are purposefully kept out of the gendered workforce and their cheap labor is exploited by the men. It happens because of social construction. Women got the chance to come in mainstream workforce during World War II. Men joined military at that time. Resultantly, women came out to do agricultural and industrial work. They got the chance to work like men, and they proved that they can do that quite well. But when men came back from war, then the scenario was changed again. When men came back, they were surprised to see that women are doing all the work which they were thinking that women cannot do. Men faced insecurity from women workforce. At this stage, the patriarchy came out and they started exploiting the women. Besides this, dependency theory also faced some criticism. This theory explains how traditional feudal structures of exploitation like race, caste, or class in colonies were used by present developed countries. It does not examine how power relations of gender within colonies matter for development. Furthermore, theorists of dependency theory does not analyze the exploitation of women's labor by multinational corporations under World Trade Organization. In short, keep in mind that dependency theory explained a system of world where some countries exploit the other countries. Same pattern is prevailing in the context of gender relations. Some genders are exploiting the others. We can take an example of men versus women. Men are exploiting women in a number of societies. Only developed countries are those countries in which women are enjoying their full rights. All the underdeveloped countries are developing countries where there are women living in miserable conditions and men are exploiting them in these countries. So the relation which developed by the dependency and world system theory for countries of the whole world can also be seen in the relation between genders. In world system, core countries exploit periphery countries and semi-periphery countries, and same is there in gender relations. Men are exploiting women. So this was all from today's lecture. The lectures on gender studies will be continued in coming videos. Thanks for watching this video. Like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell icon for more videos. Goodbye. Stay connected.